These ahadith predict, firstly, a continuation of wars from the time of the Sahaba up until Judgment Day, or more to be more precise, up until the Great War. But secondly, there are a number of ahadith that mention civil war between the Muslims towards the end of times, a massive war that will take place between the Muslims. And also, there's a series of ahadith that mention a big war between Muslims and an ally and a non-Muslim. So Muslims with one group of non-Muslims versus another group of non-Muslims. And also, this is genre number two. And then genre number three, there are ahadith about the big war. In Arabic, it is called Al-Malhamatul Kubra. This is a prophetic term. Al-Malhama. Malhama means the disaster, the catastrophe, or the bloodshed. Malhama, just the bloodshed. And this is the equivalent of the Christian concept of the Armageddon. So there are a number of ahadith that mention a civil war. That's not the Armageddon. That's before the Armageddon. Then there are hadith that mention a big war, but not quite the big war. So there will be a big war, but not the big war. And this is all ijtihad, because some ulama have merged them all together. And then there are hadith that mention the big war. And of course, the big war, the malhama, is between Isa and Dajjal. That is the end, the final battle that will take place. After that, there might not be any more wars. After that, as we're going to come to later on, that might be the end of all wars, and then other things will happen after that. So, first and foremost, a series of continual battles, mini battles. The Prophet ﷺ predicted, once the sword is unsheathed from my ummah, it will never be put back. This is a generic hadith. The Muslims will be continually fighting petty battles from the time of the Sahaba. Major battles took place, Battle of Siffin, Battle of Jamal. Continuation throughout Islamic history, Muslims have been fighting one another. You look at right now what's happening, Muslims are fighting one another, right? This is standard, it's going to happen. Then there will come a time where there will be major wars between the Muslims. And there will come a time between, there will be a major war between Muslim and non-Muslim on one side and one other non-Muslim on the other. Now, whether this is going to be before and after the big major war between Muslims, we don't know. We don't know. And then it will conclude with what? With the big war, the Malhamatul Kubra. So today, inshallah ta'ala, let's discuss some of those traditions and get a clear understanding of what this notion is. We begin with the famous hadith in Sahih, in the Tariq of Ibn Asakir, which is oft quoted many times. It is an authentic hadith where Abdullah ibn Hawala said, we were with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and we complained to him how poor we were and that we didn't even have clothes to wear. We're complaining to him. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, rejoice, don't worry about that. For I am not worried that you will live in poverty. La wallah, I'm not worried that you're going to live in poverty. Wallahi, this ummah will be in continual good until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens up the lands of the Faris, the Persians, and the lands of the Romans, that's the Byzantine Empire, and the lands of Himyar, that is Yemen. So in Mecca, the Prophet ﷺ predicted, don't worry, we will conquer the Persian Empire, and that happened. And we will conquer the Byzantine Empire, and that happened. And we will conquer Yemen, and all of that happened. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, you will become three armies. So he said, you will become. This is the ummah. This is the civil war we talked about between the Muslims. You will become three armies. Jund bil-Sham, wa jund bil-Iraq, wa jund bil-Yemen. An army will be in Sham, an army will be in Iraq, and an army will be in Yemen. And wealth will be so much that a man will be given 100 dinars. Now 100 dinars, maybe if I were to say in our times, like $5,000. It's a large amount, but not an obscenely large amount. 5,000 is no joke. 100 dinars is a good amount of money, right? A person will be given 100 dinars and think, nah, this is nothing. This is not a good amount. In other words, wealth will be so much that a good amount of wealth would be considered utterly trivial. Ibn Hawala said, Ya Rasulullah, when that happens, which of these three armies should I be with? Which of these three armies should I be with? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I tell you to be in the army of Ash-Sham, of Syria, because it is the chosen of Allah's people, and it is where the Qiyamah will take place. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam predicted that there will be three armies, an army in Ash-Sham, an army in Iraq, and an army in Yemen. And he told Ibn Hawala, choose the army in Ash-Sham. I already mentioned another hadith that I mentioned right before going for Hajj. We mentioned that when I mentioned the concept of the Mahdi. We went over this hadith quickly. It is in the six books, the authentic hadith, Sunan Ibn Majah, where our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this is about the Mahdi. We jumped to the Mahdi part. There was a phrase there I glossed over, and that is, يقتتل عند كنزكم ثلاث كلهم ابن خليفة. Three sons of a Khalifa will fight amongst you at your treasures, for your treasures. What treasure is this? Some have said this is the treasure in Mecca. There was a treasure buried once upon a time. But the hadith doesn't mention Mecca, and it is my opinion, it doesn't make sense to interpret it as Mecca. Rather, there will be a treasure of the Ummah. Oil, natural resource, Allah knows best. There will be a treasure belonging to the Ummah. And three sons of a Khalifa, three princes, all of their fathers are royal family, all of their fathers are ruling. So three sons of a Khalifa will fight one another. So these are within the Ummah. This is the internal civil war that we talked about. And none of them will be victorious. They're all three gonna fail. None of them will be victorious, and then the black flags will come from Khorasan, and then the Mahdi, and then the hadith goes on. So we jump to the Mahdi, but where does it begin? There will be an internal civil war. And what this hadith shows is that the Mahdi will come at a time when the Muslim Ummah itself is internally fighting. And the Mahdi will unify the Ummah from within. This is pretty clear that the Mahdi will unify the Ummah. The Ummah will need a leader. The Ummah will need somebody they can trust, somebody whose integrity is beyond doubt, and the person that they will look to and the person they will unanimously go behind is none other than the Mahdi. So there will be massive civil war, but the Mahdi comes and that civil war will be finished, because how can now you fight when the Mahdi is there? So this is a very clear indication that there shall be a time of massive internal civil war between the Ummah. And frankly, when you look at what is happening now with the internal superpowers, and I don't like mentioning names, but you use your common sense and knowledge of politics. Right now, there's already massive wars going on. Right now, Muslims are dividing amongst themselves, each one of them doing its own, and Muslims are being harmed in the process. Allah musta'an. What's even worse, by the way, is that these are being used by non-Muslims, right? The problem comes, the superpowers of the world are using their proxies in these regions. Each one of them thinks that they will be the lapdog of the big superpower. In reality, the superpowers never care about their lapdogs. In any case, I go into my tangents here. What I'm saying, we should be slightly terrified. No, we should be very terrified, looking at what is happening in the world and looking at these ahadith about the end of times, and Allah knows best. So this is the issue of the internal war.